It is not just another event on the calendar. This is also not just a ceremony with a military flavor. It is, however, a precious moment when people who cherish justice, freedom, and peace reflect on the ultimate sacrifice made by so many brave men and women in the two great wars. As one historian put it, they were there for reasons only known to fate. But for them, many of the freedoms we often take for granted today may have remained a distant dream.
Excuse me. Rainbow Party! 1, 2, 3! Prepare! Cenotaph Party! Lower all your arms! Remember! Thank you.
Lieutenant!
Thank you.
veterans, stand first. Remainder, stand up.
Thank you.
Stand up! I...
sisters and brothers. On this day of remembrance, we meet to pay our tribute to all those who gave their lives in the cause of freedom in two world wars, especially those who served in defense of this land of ours and are here commemorated. Join with me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. We sing together our opening hymn, Thine Be the Glory.
Let us commend to God's care all those who have made that supreme sacrifice. Remember, O Lord, all those, the brave and the true, who have died the death of honor and are departed in the hope of resurrection to eternal life. In that place of light, when sorrow and mourning are far banished, give the spirit of happiness and peace which comes from living close to our dear ones and being one in thee, until the time comes when we meet in thy kingdom and death is swallowed up in victory. the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us pray for the guidance of all the statesmen of all nations. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, guide, we beseech thee, the nations of the world into the ways of justice and truth, and establish among them the peace which is the fruit of righteousness, that they may become the kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us sing together, Eternal Father, strong to save.
Hey! sweet about the ocean.
It is not just another event on the calendar. This is also not just a ceremony with a military flavor. It is, however, a precious moment when people who cherish justice, freedom, and peace reflect on the ultimate sacrifice made by so many brave men and women in the two great wars. As one historian put it, they were there for reasons only known to fate. But for them, many of the freedoms we often take for granted today may have remained a distant dream.